boys.
Hey there, guys. It's SCMothership checking in, and it's been a while. I missed you guys, every single one of you. But yeah, been busy with a lot of stuff in school. Yeah, just a lot of things kind of stacking up here as the school year goes on. Normal day for me actually kind of consists of, just so you guys kind of get an idea, because a lot of stuff hasn't been coming out in the last week, I'd say. Mainly because, like, a normal day for me goes like this. Come home, or I mean, I go to school, obviously. I wake up, like, at 6, gotta get to school around 7-ish. And then I go the whole day, whatever. And before I was getting out early, like 1:45-ish, I was able to get home, you know, come home, do some stuff. And then do, you know, schoolwork and whatnot. And then participate in a couple of online tournaments. But now I'm starting to do track after school and stuff, so that kind of goes into the day. And then plus, a lot of times on my way home, I have to stop by people's houses to get stuff or to do some work with them or something like that. So normally I don't even get home till 4, at which point I get home at 4 and I participate in a lot of daily tournaments. Like I play in the Zeke online daily and stuff like that, and I play in play him as well. And they start like around 4. Well, so Zeke's been doing some side tournaments that start at 4, but that's not normal. But so normally like 5 to 6-ish around that area. So when I get home at 4, it means I got like an hour to practice, like to get warmed up, and then I play in those tournaments. At which point, I don't get done till about 8, and then 8 comes along, and then I have to actually do my homework, like once I'm done in the tournament. So you can kind of see why I haven't been releasing a lot of stuff, but I'm here. I'm doing my warm-up games. I figure, well, hell, if I'm not going to be releasing stuff, you know, custom games or whatnot, I might as well at least record the games that I'm playing in my warm-up. So this is actually the second game I've played today. First one was a PvP and I won it. You can see actually I haven't been playing much ladder. Most of it's just basically been me coming home, just playing a quick, like, few custom games and then with friends, and then going into the tournaments. Let's see, playing against a Terran, CharlieSheen to be exact. Hopefully he won't be winning. But yeah, so that's kind of my excuse for the absence of videos on the channel. Also, to be fair, I've just been incredibly lazy. And I haven't been playing much Starcraft, like, in general, for the last month or so. Got a new keyboard. I think you guys already heard it, though, before. This isn't the first time you've heard the ridiculously loud mechanical keyboard here. Sorry, just alt-tabbing out really quick. Talk to someone on Skype. But yeah, generally in a PvP here, I like to go for a one-gate expo. Really, pretty good opening. Really tired today, too. Actually, on my way home today, a friend, so normally I walk home, watch, I run home, technically. But normally I go home by foot. That's what I'm trying to say here. I go home by foot. Luckily today, actually, a friend happened to drive by and he picked me up and gave me a ride. But he actually offered me to go have lunch with him and stuff. So didn't get home until about the time I would have normally if I walked. But I got to have a nice like lunch sort of deal going on there. A little bit of lag. It's kind of pissing me off. It's probably because I got so much background processes going on while I'm rapsing. Oh, I am probably getting 1-1-1'd here. In which case. Wow, he must have surrounded that with like 3 probes or 3 SCVs or something, because that thing went down fast. That ghost of grab. That was awesome. Yeah, hold up. I need to turn off a few background programs. So I got too much stuff running in the background. It's actually kind of lagging me. I've actually got a stream open right now in the background. Let me turn that off. There we go. Probably should turn off my. Yeah. And we'll turn off Skype as well. So that should... Let me just... Alright. Wait for him to give me the okay here. Also, that'll help out a bit. I don't know what that's doing here in the I really don't know what that was doing there, to be honest. Kind of chilling there in the natural, but that's fine, I guess. You have not enough minerals. Oh, why is it still lagging? Not? Maybe it is fraps. I don't know. I don't normally have this problem though. It's weird that it'd be doing it now. Especially just in like a 1v1. I'll go stop her. Always indecisive on that second unit. Always indecisive. Damn, I was trying to make the. We are the blades of ire. Damn, I almost got that pro intercept. Oh, come on, man. That was bullshit. Alright. Anyways, he's gonna die, anyways. So that's good. Oh, that kinda sucks. Got supply block. Too busy being a dick. Pompous jackass, microing a zealot around. Almost getting the interception. I guess I could have used that code to put the gateway. But yeah, but since I'm pretty confident in the fact that I'm getting 1-1-1, very well. I tend to do like a 3-gate robo sort of build, get Colossi out ridiculously fast, and use that to hold off any sort of aggression here. Complete. Whoa! Uh oh, gonna lose that. Yep. Okay, so this is actually 3 racks. Because they gotta get an immortal out. A mortar. An immortal. Kinda, it really sucks to lose that stalker so fast, but shit happens. Whoa, don't want him to see that. Is he gonna see the immortal? Damn, scans last forever. I always hate that about this game. Going on in his face. Thanks. Yeah, so definitely 3 racks coming off. He's probably gonna scan and try and bust his way. Oh, he's got a command center though. Actually, wow, he doesn't have much. I could probably go kill him. At least put some aggression on. You have not enough minerals. It's getting more up there though. Damn it. Whoa, okay, this is really bad. Yeah, that was way overextension. I did not realize my units were that shitty. What the hell? Everything just melted. I've never had that happen before. Forgot that Protoss units were so shitty against Terran units. Oh well, I think I'll be fine though. Save the immortal. That's good, I guess. I guess.
State thy bidding.
We are the blade.
You require my skill.
You require more vest. You have not enough minerals.
I am here.
You have not enough minerals.
Oh well, that's why this is practice. That's why this is warm up. Test things, you know. I tested to see if my units could break that. They couldn't. But we learned something, right? That's the most important part, actually. It's testing out new things. And if you don't try stuff like that to take stuff... I mean, in hindsight, it was pretty dumb to try and just attack that. Maybe if the force field had gotten off a little bit quicker, it could have been different. But either way, I mean, he had the high ground, plus Alternians are ranged, so it's not like it would have really blocked the attack of any unit. All it would have done is... All it would have done is actually just block myself and partition some units on the ramp so that maybe a few units wouldn't be attacking. I need to get one zealot or one of those things. Overexerted. I've got some pretty damn fast colossi, I just realized.
State thy bidding.
I'll put a pylon in there just to Yeah, I'm surprised. You know, I think his drop or his medevacs are extremely delayed. Normally, would have seen like a drop timing right there, but I didn't see any like any form of. Oh, dude, I could totally kill him right now. I said that last time, and I'm like, oh, shouldn't have done that. But he's got these colossi actually are just wrecked. Three colossi, yeah, I like this. I think we'll be fine here. I think he might just die. Oh shit, he could see that. You saw nothing. Forgot I had it built a proxy pylon. Wow, he actually did a lot of he was actually able to clean that up. But he lost so many probes, I mean, kind of fine. I mean, SUVs. See, what I need to be careful of now is he's probably gonna try and do some sort of drop play. Because he needs something to get back in it after having taken losses like that. Could potentially watch. He's got a lot of immortals though. I mean, those things that kill everything in like two shots. Marauders. Immortals. He's got a third though. That kind of sucks. I've got one technically.
You have not enough minerals. You must place your minerals.
If I'm not playing well. I'm glad that this is just a practice game.
You have not enough minerals.
Yeah, I'm actually gonna build that. I'm just gonna charge out. Uh-oh. Where'd all the units go? There they are. Pay no attention.
You have not enough minerals. I like for life. My meditation. You require. We cannot hold.
Wow. How do you come back from that? There's no way that the second base could have, Huh, I'm gonna have to watch the replay on that. I killed so many SCVs. Was it just because he had mules? Like, he had three base mules, so it kinda didn't matter how many SCVs he lost? Because his gas production is gonna be the same. You can put his, you know, you can only have so many guys in gas. So he's gonna saturate this gas, so gas isn't a problem for him, so... I guess just because he had three base mules, it kind of didn't matter how many SCVs they killed. Because once you get three base mules, like... Also, a lot of it's attributed to that early game push. I just played terribly, to be fair. But he didn't play that well either. Neo's played well. There's not too much to learn about this, but I'm just really curious as to... How, when I killed all that stuff, that he was able to get such a strong force up. Yeah, this is bad. Hold up. Let's go back to this. This is just really bad. There you go. For one, I don't even know if I led with my stalkers. I mean, with my zealots. Yeah. Okay, hold up. Do a little in-depth analysis. Not that you should you should concentrate on engagements like this, but he's got three racks, right? And he's been muling, so that means that he's gotten an insane amount of minerals. So this is an exceptionally strong one base right here. It's a really bad time to push. If the like force field had maybe been like right here, and it actually split like these few units off, I could have maybe pulled back the zealots, but even still, the marauders do so much. Like, I would lose the stalkers, right? Almost instantly, and I think that's actually what kind of happens here. Hold back there, and the zealots, they all kind of evaporate. And yeah, and then the stalkers go down. And look how fast the sentries go. Dude, only three marines were really out of that fight as well. And the marines were even in position to shoot the sentries, so really all I did was... I did nothing, actually. That was a really bad position of poor engagement on my part. But what one good thing it did allow me to do is get the expansion up. Unfortunately, it's going to actually probably be later than him because he's probably going to lift this orbital up and put it down. Yeah. And it'll be down there before I get mine up. He's going to saturate that really quickly. And it's got, you know, a good amount of harvesters. I'm probably not producing them. Oh, I am right now. But I've got Colossi out. Really nice Colossi timing. And it actually comes back to save me. And in fact, if I had maybe pushed again with this first Colossi, it probably wouldn't have been good. Because odds are I would hit either right before Stim finishes or right when Stim finishes. That would be unfortunate. But the thing is, he had that orbital up really quickly, so that's why he's got a few more harvesters than me. Even though I have the ability to chrono boost, but because, I'm not producing probes right now. There we go. But because I only had one base for a little bit while, and because going one gate expand... Well, I didn't actually do one gate expand one of my sentries. Yeah, getting this one Colossi out helped so much. But I ended up still losing quite a bit there. We see it actually evens up a bit. A little bit in my favor, 100 minerals in my favor. But as far as, you know, harvesters go, he's way ahead. He's already got a third main built, so this is actually pretty... Wow, if I'd actually countered right then, I don't know why I didn't counter. I think it's because I was really low on units. But yeah, if I'd countered right then and there, actually the game would have been over. Look at that, he's got nothing. I even saw that. Oh yeah, and I saw that he had nothing. I was like, I'm going to go attack. But, yeah, I want to see what happens here at this engagement. See what kind of production. Wow, he got a lot of infrastructure up. But this double Colossi timing actually. It's pretty good. Everything kind of has. He had a really nice arc. My zealots, that was a big problem there, if you saw. My zealots were in the back there. I didn't really micro this fight. I honestly thought the game was going to end here. There's so many... so much stuff going. What are these guys attacking? What are his upgrades? Well, I did have 1-1, so that plays a pretty big part in this battle. That's what, yeah, I play this game really weird, though. Like, I don't normally play this style, unless it's against 1-1-1. Which is why the follow-up isn't so good, because I'm normally expecting an all-in Terran. But yeah, he had this 4th up, and actually I thought I killed off a lot more than I did. And I did kill off quite a lot of Harvesters, it actually evened everything up. The problem is I didn't have a 3rd to follow up, and I don't have mules. If I'd played maybe a little bit, what could I have done differently? That's what I want to know. What could I have done differently? And I think, like, this last surge here, like, if I had maybe held this off, things would have been... I don't know what I could have done differently. I mean, obviously there was decision-making early on that would have affected this, but I mean, as we saw, I had poor decision-making in the beginning. That put me behind, but then his poor decision-making to attack my natural put him behind, which really evened out the game. We saw that. But the Harvester difference, I mean, I don't know what the difference could have been, because, I mean, he got that command center. I can't do anything to stop the command center. I know that. But there are things, I guess if I had one gate expanded, that would have been different. But the problem with that is if you one gate expand against 1-1-1, technically that's like the counter, but it's actually a lot harder to use as a defense against a 1-1-1. It's a lot more fragile, and if there's Banshees involved, you need really crisp obs timings and obs positioning. And if it's not like an obs, if it's like Siege Tank Marine, then you can sometimes just die because you don't have an immortal out to take out the tanks, or you don't have Colossi out to take out the Marines. And what you really need are Colossi if you're gonna do like a gate expand. But yeah, and then the game kind of ends here. That mass Marauder style kind of sucks as Protoss. Marauders kill everything on the ground. That is. I'm trying to think of one Protoss unit. Well, I guess Zealots when you get charged. That's exactly why I was getting charged up too, because I saw how many Marauders he had. But he just had really good timing there. Yeah. Upgrades, that's another thing. And my macro would have been a little bit better. Things might have been different, but not by much. The Mule really helped him a lot in that last game. Anyways, guys. SCMothership checking out. That was my loss. Good loss, though, for the day, because it really shows why you shouldn't try to... change your style up in the middle of a game. I guess I wasn't really... I don't know what I'm trying to say here, but... it was a good game to learn from, just because I made a lot of mistakes, I guess. Good warm-up game. See you guys. That's the most I'm checking out.